Jed Forrest, obviously disappointed after last week's loss to Melrose at the Kelso Sevens final. They'll look to go one better and come away with the silverware. Regardless of what, Jed will lead the Kings of the Sevens table tonight. And if Selkirk were to win, they will be 1 point behind them. So Selkirk, Jed will be on 14, Selkirk on 13 if Selkirk were to win. But anything can happen in the final. We're underway then. Ross Goodfellow in possession inside his own 22. Feeds the ball out to Ewan Scott. Ewan Scott trying to break the tackle. He does. He feeds it back to Greave. Comes out then to Ferguson along the line to Ross Goodfellow. Goodfellow cuts inside. Nice offload taken on by Robert Ferguson. Ferguson on his own. He offloads into Gregor Young. Gregor Young though caught by Hartness. Midry just inside the Jed Forrest half. Selkirk working their way to try and get this ball back. And it does come back. Picked up then by Ewan Scott. Scott up to the halfway line. Tried to feed into Lewis Young, but it's picked up now by Fraser Hartness. Hartness away for Selkirk. Can he offload? He does to Gavin Craig. Up to the Jed 22. Gavin Craig cutting inside now. He needs the support. He's got it from Lee Jones. Jones trying to go around Hogg. He does, and it's going to be first blood to Selkirk in this final. And it's Lee Jones that goes in for the try. He goes round Robert Hogg. Hogg couldn't catch him, and he touches down. So it's a tap and go here for Selkirk. Hartness then on the ball. Taps and goes. Feeds out to Ross Nixon. Inside that Jed Forrest 22. Back into Hartness. Hartness along the line to Cal Marshall. He's got a bit of space here. Marshall breaks the tackle. He could be in here, Marshall. Oh, does he touch it down? He does. Right in the left-hand corner. And it's Selkirk's second try in this final. It's Selkirk 10. It's Jed Forrest nil. Gavin Craig looking to add the extras from that Callum Marshall try. Here we go then. Not a bad effort as he swung that one round. I'll tell you what, he's nailed it. A great kick from Gavin Craig. It's now Selkirk 12. It's Jed Forrest nil. And Jed have not been inside the Selkirk half. Inside that Jed Forrest 22, Selkirk 12, Jed Forrest nil. A try from Lee Jones and from Callum Marshall, and it's Ross Nixon on the ball now for Selkirk, locking his way up to that try line. Tackled well though. It was good tackling, and there was Gregor Young that put the tackle in, but Selkirk still attacking that Jed try line, keeping good ball retention. Here's Hartness, swings it out wide, comes out to Gavin Craig along the 22, out to Lee Jones. Jones trying to go around Robert Hogg, stops, checks, he's going the long way around Jones. He's been taken to the ground, and it's Hartness who spots a gap, and Hartness is right through the middle, and he does. Over for yet another try. Selkirk 17 is Jed Forrest nil.
The gap was there, it opened up and three went.
Yeah, conversion was missed though by Gavin Craig right in front of the post, so the scoreboard reads Selkirk 17 is Jed Forrest nil. Just outside the Jed Forrest 22, Fraser Hartness, the man that's going to put this ball in. Could be one against Ed, is it? No. Hartness feeds it out to Nixon, out to Lee Jones. Lee Jones in the stand side here, feeds it back into Ross Nixon. Nixon trying to go around his man, tackled well though by Ferguson of Jed as the ball comes back out. Well won, and that's picked up by Robert Hogg. Hogg then feeds it outside to Ferguson, down the stand list side here at Philip Hawk, but Hartness comes in to steal, and Hartness and Goodfellow coming together there, but Johnson picks up now for Selkirk. He can't offload that ball, picked up on the halfway line, and it comes out to Lewis Young. Lewis Young right down the middle, good bit of running from the Jed youngster, and he's going to go in for Jed's first try, and that will just give him a bit of hope there. Lewis Young is the man that touches down. Selkirk 17, it's Jed Forrest 5 with the conversion to come. So here comes Ewan Scott to try and add the extras in this final. Scott puts that one over, so it's now Selkirk 17, Jed Forrest 17, Jed Forrest 7, I beg your pardon. Lewis Young with that try. Well, restart comes off Rob Taylor, back into Jed hands. Is Robert Hogg on the ball at the moment? He feeds out then to Gregor Young. Gregor Young offloads to Ross Goodfellow. Goodfellow's up against Rob Taylor. Goodfellow's on his own up against Hartness. He offloads into Ferguson, back into Goodfellow, and what a try from Jed Forrest, and two tries within a minute. And they are back in this final. Well worked, Russ Goodfellow and Robert Ferguson. Ferguson took the hit, took the knock, but he offloaded to Goodfellow, who goes in to finish off that move. It's now Jed Forrest 12. It's Selkirk 17. Conversion to come.
Conversion to come, and it's. I mean, I think the referee's actually saying it's half time, or is he not? but
it will be half time once his conversion attempt from Ewan Scott,
and he makes no mistake with that.
Yeah, pitch it over, he adds extras. So from 17-0 down, Jed Forrest trail by only 3 points. 10 minutes to go then. It's going to be Jed Forrest to kick off this second half here at Phillip Hawk. It is the Selkirk Sevens final, and Ewan Scott going for the deep kick, taken well by Marshall, picked up by Ross Nixon. Selkirk along their own 22 at the moment. Lee Jones in possession, the ball fed back inside to Nixon. In fact, it was Callum Marshall out to Harkness. This time it's picked up by Rennick, who's come onto the field of play in this second half. Andrew Rennick trying to go around, but it's eventually taken down just outside the Selkirk 22. But Selkirk recycle through Harkness, comes out to Nixon along the line now as it comes out to Lee Jones. Jones will try and find the gap, and Jones is through. Jones is away, could be away here for Selkirk as Ross Goodfellow can't get him. And now Gregor Young and Lewis Young is chasing. Lewis Young trying to chase Lee Jones, and that's great speed from Lee Jones. What a start in this second half. Selkirk extending the lead. Selkirk 22 is Jed Forrest 14.
You know, Lee Jones has spent the summer in the gym, and I think it's just shown there, because all the time that run in there right for the halfway line, you know, he was just toying with the Jed defender, because he kept looking over his shoulder, just seeing where he was. And fantastic score there from Lee Jones, and I think all the hard work that he's done in the summer in the gym here at Phillip Hawk, I think it's just paying dividends.
Yeah. Fair play though to Lewis Young, who
tracked him.
He never gave up. Grieve tries to go in there, but they've whipped the ball out. Well worked by Gregor Young on the halfway line. I'll tell you what, Gregor Young's away, he beats Callum Johnston, and Young's all the way. Can he go? Oh, he's just about a metre short. He needs the support. Great tackle. Great tackle there. I think it was Marshall that got back for Selkirk, but certainly caught, but the Selkirk have been penalised. But great running from Gregor Young. Now Jed looking to get the ball out wide, comes out to Ewan Scott. Scott comes inside and he's going to touch down, and it's game on again. It's Jed Forrest 19, it's Selkirk 24. 5 minutes to go in this final. Ewan Scott is the man that cuts in. They're going to make a change. Jed Michael Weekly is going to come on. I think he's going to come on for Ferguson, I think, and also Ewan Ford is going to come on now for Selkirk, and he's going to replace Callum Johnston. So changes afoot for both sides here, but by heck, if this conversion does go over, it doesn't. It's missed by Ewan Scott. 5 points separating them. Selkirk 24, it's Jed Forrest 19. Nixon cuts inside, he's going for a wee run. Ross Nixon then working his way up to the halfway line. 2-on-1, will he make the tackle? Good tackle there from Gregor Young, and that's a good bit of fighting on the ground as well. Ewan Ford goes in for Selkirk. Now where's the ball coming? It's may come back on the Jed Forrest side. No, it's come back on the Selkirk side. Kieran Beattie out to Callum Marshall. Play 10 metres inside the Selkirk half. Selkirk 24, Jed Forrest 19. Lee Jones kicks ahead into space. It may bounce kindly for him. It does. And here comes Lee Jones. Oh, out to Andrew Rennick. Has it gone far? I think it has. But I'll tell you what, Gregor Young, he had to do that right into Lee Jones. But, there's nothing he could do about it there. But certainly, I've been impressed with these young boys for Jed Forrest. They are just not giving up. Penalty. Jed has to run it. It's Selkirk 24, Jed 19. We are going into injury time in this final. Jed just inside the Selkirk half. It comes out to Grieve, then to Michael Weekly. Weekly tackled well though by Ewan Ford. It's a steal. Selkirk have it. It's a steal. Jed driving forward. Donald Grieve does well to go back in there, but they've knocked it on Jed Forrest, and I think that could be it. It's going to be all over here, and it is. And what a final at Phillip Hawk. It finishes Selkirk 24, Jed Forrest 19, but by heck, what a final we've had here.
Well, it's the first time Selkirk's done the hat-trick. Must be mightily proud.
Oh yeah, it's a great feeling, The boy's stuck in really well today, and never let his down at all, so.
Given the weather and that, I think we put on a, especially the last two ties, we put on a good show today. We played some good rugby and that. It was a hard final the last 10 minutes, well, not the last 5 minutes, you know. Really hard going against Jed, but came through it in the end, and it's really good to get another win, 3 on the trot.
A word about the support as well. They never let you down?
Oh, no, they never let us down. Well, conditions like this, I didn't expect there to be as much support today, but they've all come out and cheered us on right to the end, so really good.
Played well right through to the final, and we just had that 10 minutes that just never turned up, and it cost us in the end, but it's great to get some points for King of the Sevens, because we're usually slow starters and now we're sitting top, so it's something to look forward to at the end of the season.